think we brought a perspective just by choosing this product. So if we had been a team with a lot of men, perhaps this product would have been discarded for being, well, it's not a problem, it works fine the way it is.
We asked them, so what would happen if we put together a product team with all women? As we already know, diversity creates creativity. By adding women's perspective to a male-dominant business will absolutely make a big difference.
I mean, there is stuff to do. I mean, and it's also like a product that has looked the same for a long time. Does it have to look like this? Does the wheels have to be like this?
To choose the product was quite a hard process. We got more than 500 suggestions from the public. There were things related to health and workout equipment and shopping and lots of things to do with cars in different ways. We had an important discussion, the product team, that we wanted to develop something that make a difference for everyone. We finally agreed on a product that hasn't been changed for almost 100 years.
Even if you're connected to the cable, you have to go back and check if they really
light.
In the team, we felt that this product was interesting because we had a feeling that women were intimidated by it. And our studies showed that a lot more women than men would rather avoid driving with a trailer at all. Well, apart from being heavy and dirty and not very ergonomic, you need a fully functional body in order to attach wires and the cable, and you need to be able to bend and squat and reach under the car. Apart from that, you use a product so seldomly that it's easy to forget the steps, and this creates an uncertainty and makes you nervous as a user, and it's never good to feel nervous when you're driving.
The best thing with our solution is that we now have removed a lot of steps, and the process is now totally automatic. You don't even have to get out of your car anymore.
With this new concept, we decided to get rid of the old-fashioned tow bar. Instead, the trailer connects to the car through the automatic docking connection.
The idea is to take advantage of the smartness that already exists in cars today. When the car is close enough, it identifies the trailer using onboard sensors. To get in the right position for docking, the car and the trailer communicates through the cloud, and so the car backs up and connects to the trailer autonomously. A mechanical lock inside secures the trailer, and a checklist on the car display gives the driver all the relevant information. Then it's safe to drive.
For any designer, it's an important mindset never to design for yourself, but to get to know your intended users. But I think it's easier to assume that people think and act the same way that you do if you belong to a norm. And in product development, especially in tech products, the norm is that you are a man.